Malolele friends, talofa lava, nisambula, bakalofala hiatu, and good day to everyone tuning in to the CSU Climate Festival. It's so great to be here, and we want to first and foremost give thanks to our God for providing us this opportunity, our sustainer, to share some love with the wider community on how we can work together in climate change. We want to acknowledge the first peoples on the land we gather, the Darug Nation of the Barramattical people. We want to pay our respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging. We have our generations come from, and our foremothers come from, the islands of Fiji, so Kondabu land, and we are excited to show that off today, as well as our Tongan traditions and culture, for you guys to come and embrace about why we love the land and the resources that it brings. So Lawaki, why are you motivated for climate change?
Climate change motivates me because being the line that we come from people that used to live off the land, you know, be so resourceful in everything that they use, whether that be on the land or in the sea. And so by utilizing techniques and things that they used back then, it really motivates me to see how we can change some of the things that we do today into a more sustainable way of production kind of thing.
Yeah, I love that. So today we are talking about the drum roll. We are talking about the
coconut.
Tell us more.
So pretty much the coconut is the tree of life. Everything from the actual tree itself is 100% reusable, and you can use it time and time again, whether that be the palms, the trunk, or its fruit, or even what's inside the fruit. You can 100% reuse that all the time. So what I've kind of done is made candles.
And we are going to show you that whole process today. So we are excited. My cousin, he has made these awesome candles from scratch, and we are going to use the whole thing. There is nothing going to waste, which is why we are so excited to continue to use the resources of this land and our lands back home. So we want to pay homage to our ancestors, our families back home, in what he has created, and we want to show that and let that shine. So hopefully you guys enjoy. Any last words before we begin?
No, that's it pretty much.
All right, opato.
So the first thing you want to do is take off the husk from the coconut. You can fast track this by using a sander to get a nice polished feeling. And then you want to sit it down and give it a seat by using the sand on the bottom, and that's where the candle will sit.
Cheers, everyone. Oh my gosh, this was so bomb, so good.
Alright, so now that we've cut our coconut, what we're going to do is we're going to grate it, and I'm going to show you how we grate it in Tonga. So this is called a hakalo. So in Tonga, this is what they use to grate the coconut. It's pretty much, the English version is a coconut grater. So pretty much it's just like a plank of wood with a piece of metal with spikes on the end to get inside the coconut. And I'll show you how to grate it now. Back in Tonga, what they do with the coconut flesh is they use a strainer, they tatau, or they squeeze out all the juice, and from there, that's where you can get coconut cream, coconut milk, and coconut oil.
Now we come to a time where we're going to make the actual candles.
The wax that we're using today is a blend of coconut and soy wax. Once the wax is completely melted, you want to take it off the heat.
wick holder.
Yeah.
That's the wick. So you can do some, put it in there. Yeah. Dick. This side.
After.
Once you've let your wax sit for a couple of minutes, you want to add in your fragrance oil, give it a little bit of a whirl, and then finally add it into your coconut.
So this is the waiting game. You sit and wait for approximately how long?
You would most likely wait for like
24 hours.
So from this you have using coconut oil, we use it to polish and varnish the coconut cups, take it outside and let it dry. Now these coconut candles just bring a vibe everywhere you go. But in our culture, we like to give the best away. So you can use these coconut candles, package them up, and give them to your loved ones. They're reusable, sustainable, and from the land.